Hello students, today we are going to look at an unconventional machining process, or non-traditional machining process. It is a special type of machining process in which there is no direct contact between the tool and the workpiece. In unconventional machining, a form of energy is used to remove unwanted material from a given workpiece. In these methods, thermal energy is the energy that comes from heat. Heat energy is concentrated on a small area of the workpiece to melt and vaporize the tiny bits of work material. The required shape is obtained by continued repetition of this process. Laser beam machining, LBM, is a non-traditional subtractive manufacturing process, a form of machining, in which a laser is directed towards the workpiece for machining. This process uses thermal energy to remove material from metallic or non-metallic surfaces. The laser is focused onto the surface to be worked and the thermal energy of the laser is transferred to the surface, heating and melting or vaporizing the material. Plasma arc machining, PAM. PAM is a method of cutting metal with a plasma arc, or tungsten inert gas arc, torch. The torch produces a high-velocity jet of high-temperature ionized gas, plasma, that cuts by melting and displacing material from the workpiece. Electron-beam machining, EBM, is a process where high-velocity electrons concentrated into a narrow beam are directed toward the workpiece, creating heat and vaporizing the material. Ion-beam machining, IBM. In IBM, a stream of charged atoms, ions, of an inert gas, such as argon, is accelerated in a vacuum by high energies and directed toward a solid workpiece. The beam removes atoms from the workpiece by transferring energy and momentum to atoms on the surface of the object. When an atom strikes a cluster of atoms on the workpiece, it dislodges between 0.1 and 10 atoms from the workpiece material. Electrical energy method. In these method, electrical energy is directly used to cut the material to get the final shape and size. Electrical discharge machining, EDM. EDM involves the direction of high-frequency electrical spark discharges from a graphite or soft metal tool, which serves as an electrode, to disintegrate electrically conductive materials such as hardened steel or carbide. The electrode and workpiece are immersed in a dielectric liquid, and a feed mechanism maintains a spark gap of from 0.0005 to 0.020 inch, 0.013 to 0.5 millimeter, between the electrode and the workpiece. As spark discharges melt or vaporize small particles of the workpiece, the particles are flushed away, and the electrode advances. The process is accurate, but slow, and is used for machining dies, molds, holes, slots, and cavities of almost any desired shape. Wire cut EDM, electrical discharge machining. It is a process of metal machining in which a tool discharges thousands of sparks to a metal workpiece. EDM works on parts resistant to conventional machining processes, but only if these parts are electrically conductive, usually, they are non-ferrous. Instead of cutting the material, EDM melts or vaporizes it, leaving little debris and providing a very accurate line. Electrochemical energy method. In these method, material is removed by ion displacement of the workpiece material in contact with a chemical solution. ECM resembles electroplating in reverse. In this process, metal is dissolved from a workpiece with direct current at a controlled rate in an electrolytic cell. The workpiece serves as the anode. The tool, which serves as the cathode. The electrolyte, usually an aqueous salt solution, is pumped under pressure through the inter-electrode gap, thus flushing away metal dissolved from the workpiece. As one electrode moves toward the other to maintain a constant gap, the anode workpiece is machined into a complementary shape. Electrochemical grinding is a process that removes electrically conductive material by grinding with a negatively charged abrasive grinding wheel, an electrolyte fluid, and a positively charged workpiece. 1. Materials removed from the workpiece stay in the electrolyte fluid. Electrochemical grinding is similar to electrochemical machining but uses a wheel instead of a tool shaped like the contour of the workpiece. Electrochemical honing. Electrochemical process where electrolyte pumped past the rotating honing stone. The process by connecting to a power source, the workpiece acts as anode and the tool as cathode. An electrolyte is pumped past the processing area, which means that the workpiece is dissolved by the accelerated corrosion resulting from electrochemical machining, which in this process is about 90% of the cutting process. The remaining 10% is removed by the tool's abrasive honing stone, which exposes the non-corroded material faster, which accelerates the electrochemical machining. Middle dot electrochemical deburring is a method that finishes the workpiece surfaces by means of anodic metal dissolution. The electrolyte solution transfers charge in the gap between the cathode and workpiece, which causes electron transfer from the workpiece to remove surface material. Middle dot the separation distance between the cathode and the workpiece is key to regulating the material removal process. Middle dot the shape of the cathode determines the final shape of the workpiece or the impression, imaging, placed upon the workpiece. Middle dot the speed of material removal is dictated by the DC current applied. Middle dot the amount of material removed is defined by Faraday's laws. The material removed during the deburring process must be filtered out of the electrolyte stream in order to maintain constant electrolyte quality in the gap between the cathode and the workpiece. Chemical energy method. These methods involve controlled etching of the workpiece material in contact with a chemical solution. Chemical milling or industrial etching is the subtractive manufacturing process of using baths of temperature-regulated etching chemicals to remove material to create an object with the desired shape. It is mostly used on metals, though other materials are increasingly important. It was developed from armor decorating and printing etching processes developed during the Renaissance as alternatives to engraving on metal. The process essentially involves baling the cutting areas in a corrosive chemical known as an etchant, which reacts with the material in the area to be cut and causes the solid material to be dissolved. Inert substances known as maskants are used to protect specific areas of the material as resists. Mechanical energy method. In this methods, the material is removed by mechanical erosion of the workpiece material. Ultrasonic machining, or strictly speaking ultrasonic vibration machining, is a subtraction manufacturing process that removes material from the surface of a part through high frequency, low amplitude vibrations of a tool against the material surface in the presence of fine abrasive particles. An ultrasonically vibrating mill consists of two major components, a transducer and a sonitrode, attached to an electronic control unit with a cable. An electronic oscillator in the control unit produces an alternating current oscillating at a high frequency. The transducer usually consists of a cylinder made of piezoelectric ceramic. The oscillating voltage is applied to electrodes attached to the transducer, which converts the electrical energy into mechanical vibrations. The transducer then vibrates the sonitrode at low amplitudes and high frequencies. A constant stream of abrasive slurry flows between the sonitrode and workpiece. This flow of slurry allows debris to flow away from the cutting area. Non-uniform shapes to be cut into the workpiece with extremely high precision. Abrasive jet machining, AJM, also known as abrasive microblasting, pencil blasting and microabrasive blasting, is an abrasive blasting machining process that uses abrasives propelled by a high-velocity gas to erode material from the workpiece. Common uses include cutting heat-sensitive, brittle, thin, or hard materials. Specifically, it is used to cut intricate shapes or form specific edge shapes. A water jet cutter, also known as a water jet or water jet, is an industrial tool capable of cutting a wide variety of materials using a very high pressure jet of water, or a mixture of water and an abrasive substance. The term abrasive jet refers specifically to the use of a mixture of water and abrasive to cut hard materials such as metal or granite, while the terms pure water jet and water-only cutting refer to water jet cutting without the use of added abrasives, often used for softer materials such as wood or rubber. Thank you for watching. If you want more videos like this, then subscribe Chennai Minds and comment below.